Yeah! Yeah, baby! Welcome to the Dynamite Gizmo podcast, everyone. Episode 116. 116. Huh? What did you say? I can't hear you. I said 116, folks. 116, and this episode is packed full of nothing. Nothing. You're getting nothing from me. Janice? Stepping up your game. Got me some cranberry ginger ale. Last episode, she tried to kill me by putting dust in my water. This episode, she's just straight up giving me a sody pop. But you know what, Janet? Or Janice? I'm so sorry. It's not even a fucking name brand. This is President's Choice. That's a grocery store franchise. Okay? It's like the no-name brand. But it still tastes good. It's all right. It's better than fucking dusty water, I'll tell you that. Here's today's card. It's tradition around here to show you the card, but it's not tradition to show you what's on the card. But you'll find out because I'll talk about it anyway. So listen. I gotta say some shit before we get started here. So this episode will be the last episode in this studio with this back for just for a little bit. Because unfortunately, I'm in this fucking job and have been for a few years now. Every so often, when it's slow in my area, we gotta go work away in specific places, you know, far away from home. So we don't have access to come back home every night. We have to stay, you know, sometimes it's months on end. And when that happens, you know, generally that's major depression and anxiety for me. I've done it quite a few times now, and it's one of the reasons why I don't keep up with this podcast. Well, in the past. Because I would get sent away on these jobs and it would put me in such a deep depression that I had no motivation to do anything. And so, like, I literally just found out today, a few hours ago, and at first I was panicking and I was frustrated and I was, you know, the same sort of depression came over me. And I was like, fuck, this sucks. You know, because there's nothing I hate more. There's nothing I hate more than working in a job I hate. Like, this job, it's, you know, it's... I don't want to even talk about it because this podcast is my space, you know? This is my spot. So to bring my personal life, bring my job into this space, taints it. But I'm going to do a little bit of it. So I'm not going to tell you what my job is. I'm just going to say it revolves around the oil field. You know, tons of controversy around the oil field. Whatever. I don't care, okay? I live in a small town. I live in a fucking small town where this is literally all there is to do. And if you're going to do another job, it has to, you know, it's some other simple, minute job that wouldn't even pay enough to allow you to live somewhere. So anyway, it doesn't matter. I just, and I've said this in this podcast before, and I've even filmed a podcast while I was working away in the past, but I only did one like that ever. So, I'm going to be working away. I'm not going to say how long, because you never fucking know. That's the other shitty thing. So, like, I'm kind of beside my point here. What I said is, there's nothing I hate more than working a job that I hate, let alone working a job I hate in some fucking city 5, 6, 7 hours away from where I live. But for some reason, I've done it enough now, and I've been meditating every day. I've been going to therapy. It's really helping me find ways to cope with these sort of situations, and I've come to some sort of realization that it's, you know, it's never as bad as you make it out to be. My whole childhood, I grew up avoiding everything, failing a lot. Every time I would encounter a situation that I hated, I would simply run away and get far away from it rather than conquering it. And, you know, so that really didn't help me develop a sort of tolerance to this sort of thing as I got older. So from like age 18 till right up till now, I've been having to redevelop those skills, and I feel like now I'm getting to a point where I'm just starting to get comfortable in uncomfortable situations. I'm learning how to cope with them a little bit better. And so, normally, if this was a year ago or 2 years ago when I started this, there's no fucking way I would be recording this episode, because I would be in such a deep depression that I wouldn't even know what to do with myself. So, I don't know how many, the next, like, maybe 2, 3, 4, who knows? I don't know. But the episodes after this episode are going to be in a hotel room. I'm not going to be able to use my sound equipment. I'm not going to have the sound effects. I'll have them on the computer. I might do it there, but, you know, it's going to be limited and basic. But it's still going to give the essence of the Dynamite Gizmo podcast. See, because I'm working towards a point where I can just rely on YouTube and or Patreon and or whatever else. This is one of those things. This is my dream. This is my passion. This is what I wanted to do and what I've always wanted to do. And so it just sucks getting to that point, you know? Because no one, well, the odd few get handed everything they want, but the ones who truly make it and want to continue doing what they're doing, they got to build their way up. You know? You got to fucking work. You got to do shit to get there. And so that's the stage I'm at now. And I'm, you know, I long for the day when I become a success and I don't have to worry about this shit, you know? But then when I become a success, I'm going to be looking back to these days and I'm going to be like, those were simpler times. So it's, you know, can you really win? I don't even know. I know nothing. But what I do know right now is that there's nothing stopping me from doing this podcast. I'm just not stopping. And I've told myself that, and I've been consistently uploading these podcasts, and so I want to keep doing it. My goal is to become, you know, established as the podcast, a podcast person. A lot of people, you know, they start off doing something, whether it's comedy or music or, you know, anything. And then once they're established that way, then they get their podcast. But I'm kind of doing it a different way here. This is what I want. This is what I enjoy. And I have been enjoying this and I'm loving it. And so first thing I want to talk about is the Valley Folk again. I talk about them a lot, but they're such a huge inspiration for what I do here. And just yesterday, they won Bring the Funny. If you didn't know, they were on NBC's show, Bring the Funny. It's a reality comedy competition type show where different types of comedian acts, whether it's stand-up or sketch, you know, ranges from all different sorts of styles. They get on stage, they perform something, they perform their act, and then, you know, they have the competition, like American Idol. And there's three judges, Jeff Foxworthy and the other two, I can't remember. I didn't even really know who they were, to be honest. But I guess they're established comedians, and the fucking Valley Folk won. They won the whole thing. And I just finished watching their podcast, where they're discussing their emotions and how they felt about it, and it was so fucking inspiring. As corny and as cheesy as this is, it's really motivating to see the YouTubers you love and have loved for such a long time. You just get to watch them grow. You didn't get to do that back in the day with television. You can do that now with anyone you enjoy watching or interacting with online. You can watch them build their fucking career, and you can learn from them. And then on top of it all, it's just completely inspiring, because you really get to see that they're just a regular person and they still struggle with the daily life, just like everybody does. But you see how they do it and how they deal with it, and it's really relatable, but it's also inspiring, and you know, there's so many emotions, and then just seeing them succeed to this high extent is so, it's so heartwarming. I hate saying shit like this. I hate it. But you know, I'm in a fucking slightly depressive state right now because I know that I have to fucking go away to work. But I've, you know, I'm learning to cope with it. I'm learning to just say, like, okay, there's gonna be positives from this. It's not gonna be that long. You're gonna get some money, you know. But when it's all over, you feel great. But you know how it is. I'm getting better at dealing with it. Meditation is fucking great, man. If you don't meditate and you are an anxious, depressive piece of shit like me, you gotta try meditation. And don't expect it to work right away. I mean, I'm still in the beginning stages of it, but it's meditation and therapy, you know, those, the combination of them too, like, you just wouldn't think, like, how could that help? Like, what is meditation, really? But it helps. It fucking works. I use Sam Harris's app called Waking Up, and you gotta pay for it. It's like a monthly fee of $20 or something, but if you really can't afford it, he says himself you can contact him and explain your reasoning as to why you can't afford it, and he'll give it to you for free. And once you get it, use it. He has there's 50 days to get you started, and once you get those 50 days done, then, you know, then you're really starting to get into it. And I like to relate that to this podcast because, you know, when I first started, it was just like, okay, episode one, we got it's just like someone puts you in a room full of nothing. And then you're like, okay, I gotta build a fucking castle. Where do I start? And where's this gonna go? It's so intimidating. But then you get to episode 50 and it's like, wow, I got to episode 50. I can't believe this. And you're like, I wonder if I can get to episode 100. And then you get to episode 100 and it's like, fuck, I actually did it. And then it's kind of a bit easier at that point. You're like, well, okay, maybe I can keep going. And you keep going. And it's like, all right, okay, and now what? And I haven't got to episode 150 yet, but I've got past the episode 50 and the episode 100 hurdle. Now I don't want to stop. And if I were to stop, that would just make my life miserable. So the only way to make myself happy is to continue this podcast, knowing that someday I'm going to achieve something with it. Like, I don't care if I get to, like, episode 500 and I still have no viewers. I don't want to stop. Because I know what it's like to be on YouTube, and I've seen, I say this way too often, but I will continue to say it. I've been on YouTube since day one. Haven't made content since day one, but pretty well since day one, and you know, not consistently, though. That was my problem. I had a bad issue with keeping up with it. But I've seen people. I've seen how people progress and do their stuff. And they go, you know, they got their ups and their downs and their ins and their outs. And it's, you really gotta just take the time and put in the effort. And let it happen. Just get it out there. Just get the content out. Obviously make it quality, but get it out there. It's tough. Because life is tough. And life gets in the way of the things you would like to do. But if you just say, I got time, I'm going to do it. And you just sit down and do whatever it is you want to do, you'll feel good afterward. And that's one of the main reasons why I do this podcast. And so with an episode like today's, it's not typical that I... Well, it is kind of, but... You know, I try to centralize this podcast as like a comedy-based type ordeal with a little bit of... You know, whatever I fucking am thinking about throughout the week or whatever. But I like to throw in a lot of comedy into the mix. But, you know, like I've said before, there's going to be episodes where I'm not on that level, you know? And I don't want to fake it. I don't want to be fake on camera, because there's nothing I hate more than people who are faking it. And you can obviously tell that what they're doing is not genuine. So, yeah. Had to do it, man. I had to do it. Can't go an episode without a little. Right? I wonder if Dynamic Banter fans are going to watch this. And they're going to hear this. And they're going to be like, you fucker. You're ripping off Dynamic Banter. I don't think so. Well, probably. Everything's going to happen, but I love it. I love that sound. I love the way he says it, the little bit of music in the background. It fits perfectly into a lot of scenarios. I didn't do the white balance on the camera. I just realized that. Now, I'm a little nervous. I'm a little nervous because in the past, I told myself, you have to do the podcast while you're working away, and I just wouldn't do it. Because you usually end up working on a lot of hours throughout the day, and you get home late. Although I did do one once. It was the episode about the penny. Canada doesn't have pennies or something. That was the title of it. And that time working away was one of the worst. I remember the first like few days working away at that place. It was like major, major depression. Like, I was having to call my parents, and, like, I was crying, and it was... It sounds super, like, pathetic and sad, but it's uncontrollable for me. When I'm put in a situation where I have to completely step away from my comfort zone, it's just like, ah, what are you doing to me? And it's always, and with this job, it's always instantaneous. Like, it's, you never know when the fuck you're gonna have work. You know, it's an on-call job. So, like, you could go, like, a whole, like, just, this literally just happened. I went a full, like, week and a half with no work. And now all of a sudden it's just like, okay, pack your shit, you're leaving in 2 days to go. And sometimes it's like, pack your shit, you're leaving today to go 7 hours away. And it's like, what? Like, how can that still happen in today's day and age, you know? Like, why is it always so immediate? And the people in this town just accept it and they love it. They fucking love working in the oil field. The people who work in the oil field, who live around here, fucking love it. Not me, though. And I'm working towards getting out of here. And I'm also working toward just, you know, making a career off this. And I'm also writing a book. I've got... Well, I was kind of doing the music thing, but I don't know about that. But basically, I've written a script. I've been writing a book since grade 11, but I'm really slacking on that. This podcast is like one of the main things I'm focusing on, and it's, you know, I'm not only doing this podcast just to be able to, you know, get views and get attention and make money. I'm doing it because it actually is helping me physically and, well, mentally, I should say. Mentally, it's helping me. When I sit down here in this room and I just talk about whatever the fuck is on my mind to this camera, it's almost a form of therapy for me. And if I don't do it, I just feel like shit. But if I do it, I'm pretty okay. Like, it helps me. And it's been such a long time since I could actually say that about myself. Because, since I left high school, it's just been fucking misery every day. Of just wondering, what the hell am I gonna do? And I still... you know, worry about that, but at least I have this podcast to turn to. And it just, I don't know what I'm saying, I don't know what I'm doing. It just, the times you live in when you're building your foundation to allow yourself to be successful in whatever industry you're in. I'm talking specifically art, whatever form of art it is, it's always painful in the beginning, and it can be painful for a long time. But I just know that someday it's going to pay off, and all of that pain and, misery and depression is going to be worth it, because you stuck with it and you stuck to it and you just simply made it happen through willpower. I'm having like really, really negative thoughts coming into my head right now. And I'm just trying to push them away. Because I don't need that right now. Because I was going to just say what was on my mind, but I don't... Like, what is this? Do people even want to watch this? I'll be looking back on this episode years from now, and I'll be like, there it was. That was it. That was the moment. Those were the days. That is what needed to be done to get to where I am. But man, it's hard. It's not fun. It's not fun. And I can't say I've had a real success moment that I can actually look to and be like, oh, I'm satisfied with the way that turned out. I just haven't got there yet. I've never really succeeded at anything. Like I said earlier, like I've failed everything. I just, my whole life I lived in a depressive, anxious state, and, you know, I grew up with just a single parent, my mother, and she, you know, as great as she is, it was just, she allowed me to just run away when I was scared. And so I would just, you know, if I was frightened in a situation, I would just leave, I would give up. And then it was like, ah, glad I don't have to do that anymore. But if, you know, I mean, I'm not blaming her for anything, for any of this. I just know that if I were to just stick with it and allow myself to overcome the fears, it would have allowed me to, you know, get through things in my life more easily and stick to it. But on the other hand, maybe the fact that she allowed me to just escape the fears and, you know, build this whole whatever sort of fucking anxious brain I have, you know, maybe that is the reason why I'm so willing and so determined to just be a success in the art industry. Because you see it in every artist. They all have the same vibes and emotions about things. And, you know, they all have the fucked up background. They all are the outcasts and the people who never fit in with anyone. And, you know, it all describes who I am. And I look at the people who work in the oil field, in the industry that I'm in, and... or I should say the industry that I'm working in, I, you know, and I see them and they're just so satisfied with themselves. And I'm like, I don't relate to that. Not even the slightest. I don't know how people can be happy with themselves doing stuff like that. And you might be saying, well, why the fuck are you even in the industry if you hate it so much? Well, just kind of one of those things where I got in it when I was right out of high school, you know, I went to Vancouver film school, but then I dropped out and then I fucking came right back as usual, typical, come right back to home base. And then I'm like, okay, well, I just got to do something to make money. I just got to do it. I was desperate for money. So I got into the oil field cause that's all there was. And then I kind of just, you know, got roped in and I can't get out. I've gotten out twice, but then I keep failing and getting scared and then coming back and just accepting, you know, the oil field. And it's like, right now, I'm basically 25 years old. I'm going to be in November, and the past few months or so, I've been, you know, really focusing on getting out. Getting out and staying out. Because I feel like at this point, if I get out, no matter how shitty my life may turn out to be, no matter how desperate I feel, I would first go work at McDonald's than ever come back into the oil field. It's so against what I believe in and the kind of person I am that, you know, I don't even want to do it. You know, like, it's one of those things where when I came to Alberta, I came here at 14 years old, and I saw what was going on. I saw the type of people that were here, and, you know, the whole industry thing. And even growing up, I was like, there's no fucking way you're ever going to find me in a job like that. And lo and behold, I ended up in the fucking one position I absolutely despise. And, you know, you can make the argument that doing that is allowing me to conquer my fears, and it's going to prepare me for when I actually get into the industry of the art world. It's going to prepare me for these types of situations. And, you know, that's one of the only positives I can take from this. But other than that, I've been in the oil field since I was 18 years old. I feel like now if I could do this for anything, and if it was because I was doing it because of the fact that I wanted to get the experience and preparedness, I feel like that is done. I've gotten what I could possibly get from the oil field, and at this point, I don't want any part of it. I never wanted any part of it. And I especially don't want any part of it now. And I don't want to get to a point where I'm comfortable in the oil field and I completely forgot about my dream. Because there was a point when I first started, like, I started off as a heavy-duty mechanic in the oil field, working on oil field equipment, fixing them. And I was doing apprenticeships, and while that was happening, it was like no art was being done. And I kind of convinced myself, well, art's over. We're focusing on this now. And I was, and deep down inside, I hated myself. I was like, what are you doing? It's like growing up with a puppy or something, and then it grows up, and then you just leave it on you just leave it behind. You move away from it and you just forget about it. And the puppy's sitting there like, the puppy would be growing up into a dog and is sitting there like, what are you doing? Like, why are you forgetting about me? I thought we had this great relationship. And so I just came to this realization where I was like, fuck, man, like, what am I doing? I'm just giving up on my dream? Like, I can't. You know? Like, it's hard. Because everyone, oh my God, getting super emotional. And I'm so against this. I'm so against crying on camera, but I knew. Fuck, I knew this was gonna happen. And when I say I'm against it, I just mean, like, I hate when people do it just for the views or whatever. This is so stupid, like. This is really dumb. You're watching this right now and you're like, you probably clicked away by now, but. Fuck. It's just. My goodness gracious. It's just hard. Because people constantly tell you there's no way you can get this done. Why are you even bothering? It's like, you know, like I said, it's like trying to give up a dog that you, you know, grew up with. Like, it's impossible for me. Like, I never would have thought that I would actually come to tears on this fucking podcast. But here it is. It's happening. Yeah. Obviously, I'm going to cut this short. Like, there's really not a lot I can say. But what I will say is just, if you have a dream of doing something, whatever it is, I suggest. No. I demand that you stick to it and don't stop until you get it done. Because you'll live your life regretting that you ever gave up on it. This is so stupid. This is seriously. It's like super, super pathetic. It doesn't get any more pathetic than this. And I know you're watching. If you are still watching, you're saying, well, what the fuck, man? Why are you crying over nothing? And it's just, I don't know, it's a combination of the fact that I have to go away to work and the fact that I'm stuck in this job and I'm trying to get out of it and I can't. Like, all I've wanted more than anything is to just be a success, specifically on YouTube. And it's fucking rough. So rough. Because obviously your family doesn't understand. You know? Even most friends don't even understand. I don't know. I guess just. Like, what is this? When did I start fucking tearing up here? The last, like, fucking 15 minutes of this podcast are just gonna be me sitting here saying nothing. And it's genuine, this is not me doing this for views. I was not expecting this to happen. But it did. Whatever. It's not a big deal. It was bound to happen eventually. So the only other thing I need to say is that during the month of October, you know, it's gonna be Halloween themed. I think I mentioned this already. I'll just wait till October to fucking really announce it. Now is not the time. We just need to say, if you're feeling like shit, like I am right now, about life, just focus on the good stuff. The good things. Whatever, do whatever makes you satisfied, and then if you can't connect to people like I can't in the ways that I want to, you know, follow the people in line and stick with them. If you don't have any friends, just stick with them. Stick with the people you enjoy online. And follow in their footsteps. Don't let the world decide for you. Holy fuck. So, with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this episode, but I can almost guarantee you didn't, and you probably already exited. But if you didn't, well, I highly appreciate it. Can't see you sticking around, though, but if you did, whatever. Good for you. Thank you. Yada, yada, yada. Please like, subscribe, comment, hit that bell notification. And, next time I see you, I will be in a hotel room. I would never find myself in a situation like this. If this happened, I'd be the first one to leave. As soon as this shit started happening, I'm gone.